إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Our righteous predecessors, they used to make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would extend their lives so that they can live to observe Ramadan. They used to say, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Because in Ramadan, you have the chance, the opportunity to make up again with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Ramadan, you're given three lifelines, if I may use the term. في قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whosoever fasts Ramadan إيمانا, believing that it is prescribed upon him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, واحتسابا, hoping for the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all his previous sins. The second lifeline, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whosoever observes Salatul Qiyam, which is known by Salatul Taraweeh, again imanan, believing that it was prescribed upon him in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wahtisaban, seeking the ajr, seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all his previous sins. The third lifeline, قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whosoever observes عبادة, Qiyam here means ibadah, in the night of Al-Qadr, which is in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, again imanan, believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed this upon him in the sunnah, in the tongue of his messenger, and seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive all his previous sins. Subhanallah, deenun azeem. What a great religion we have. الدين الديانات الأخرى يقول لك somebody died in the cross for you. And لاهو. You earn your salvation as you go. You cleanse yourself as you go. You clean yourself up as you go. ولذلك يا إخوة ورد حديث في سنن ابن خزيمة ومصنف ابن أبي شيبة, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, a famous حديث, الحديث في سنن الترمذي also. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went up his pulpit, which is made of three steps, 1, 2, 3, and in the first step he said آمين, and in the second step he said Ameen, And then in the third step he said, Ameen. Then after he faced his companions, they asked him, why did you say Ameen three times? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم answered him saying, أتاني جبريل عليه السلام. As or while I was going up my pulpit, Jibril عليه السلام came and made dua three times. وأمنت على دعائه. Then I said Ameen to his dua. The first dua, رغم أنف امرئ أدرك أبواه أو أحدهما ولم يدخلاه الجنة. Basically, رغم أنف يعني a loser. This one is, he's given an easy chance, easy way to get to Jannah, and he wasted it. Someone who comes into this world and then he finds his parents, father and mother alive, or one of them, and by the virtue of his kindness to them, he does not get to Jannah. He wasted such an easy opportunity. His father, his mother, or both, if he was kind to them, they would have the reason, they would have been the reason for him to go to Jannah. But he wasted it. He was mean to them. Aminu Sama, the trustworthy of the heavens, Jibril alayhi salam, wa Aminu al-Ard, and the trustworthy of earth, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, made dua against this person. Just to show you how devastating this sin is. The second Ameen, وَرَغِمَ أَنْفُ مْرِئٍ أَدْرَكَ رَمَضَانَ وَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ. That he gets to live through Ramadan and he comes out of it unforgiven. Because of these three chances. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Basically, the agenda of this person is not to gain forgiveness. Anyone who wastes Ramadan, his agenda is not forgiveness, is not Allah. He is too occupied with the dunya. He doesn't believe in this stuff. He's not interested. A loser, someone who gets to live through Ramadan and he does not earn forgiveness. The third Ameen, وَرَغِمَ أَنْفُ مْرِئٍ ذُكِرْتُ عِنْدَهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَلَمْ يُصَلِّ عَلَيْهِ. A loser, someone, my name is mentioned in his presence and he does not say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fa ya ikhwa, yani ma ajmal, what yani, a beautiful thing that we have the chance, the opportunity. Wallahi, I want to tell you right before I came here, I went and I visited a brother who is sick in the hospital. He is in the intensive care. Subhanallah, yani, he is passing away, you can tell. And I just, you know, reflect, subhanallah, it's just 1 month away from Ramadan. 1 month away from Ramadan. So the first thing that you need to do right now is be grateful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got you to live that far. Sha'ban is coming soon and it goes by so quickly that you have a chance again to fast Ramadan. And like I mentioned earlier, before the lecture, there is nothing better that you can prepare for Ramadan but with the knowledge how to fast. A lot of Muslims, by the way, they don't even know how to fast. They think fasting is just not eating and drinking. No, fasting is far, far greater than this. There are issues of fasting. يعني أنت تخيل رب العالمين الله سبحانه وتعالى says في الحديث الإلهي كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به. All the deeds of the son of Adam are his. يعني the scholars explain this by saying the angels write it حسنات حسنات up to 700 based on his sincerity and the excellence of his ibadah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give the angels instructions to write the reward for fasting. Just say that this person fasted and it's with me. ولذلك أهل العلم لهم كلام جميل جدا في هذا الحديث. يقول لك إيه, قد تتساوى الحسنات والسيئات يوم القيامة. It's possible. We know that there are people whose deeds will end up even. اللي هم أهل الإيه, أصحاب الإيه, الأعراف, the people of the trench, the people of the wall or the trench, the wall, I'm sorry, not the trench, which is the wall between Jannah and Hell. Who are those people? Their deeds broke even. Imagine, حسنات and سيئات are even, and they will be placed in a wall between Jannah and Hell. فالله سبحانه, يعني the scholars, they say that your deeds may end up even or less than your sins, and then you find Allah bringing out your fasting. He rewarded you tremendously for your fasting because it was not counted. There is nothing better than preparing with knowledge. وكما ذكرت الحديث, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحكي عن ربه في حديث إلهي في صحيح البخاري, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. الحديث أوله, the beginning of the hadith, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Imagine this, whosoever has animosity against any of my wali, awliya, I will declare war on that person. Now be careful, how do you become wali? ما هو موضوع ولي دي, مش how, what is the curriculum to be a wali? Right here in the hadith, read the rest of the hadith. You want to be a wali? Here it is. One, وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه. My servant will not find anything which will bring him closer to me than that which I mandated upon him. ما هو الناس اللي يقول لك ايه, الأولياء التانيين دول يقول لك ايه, واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين. They don't pray. They don't pray the five daily prayers. يقول, why don't you pray? يقول, أنا ولي, أنا شيخ, أنا خلاص. لا, أهو. You have to begin from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mandated upon you. العلم بلا إله إلا الله. العلم بالتوحيد, الشهادة. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. الصلوات الخمس, the five daily prayers. الزكاة المفروضة, the 2.5%, وصوم رمضان, fasting رمضان, والحج إن استطعت, if you're able. ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. Now my servant is not going to stop at the mandatory. He will do extras. He will do more voluntary acts. He keeps up with the nawafil before and after the salas. بيصلي التهجد بالليل. Fast Mondays, Thursdays, Ashura, the 2 days of Ashura or the 1 day, the 9th of Dhul Hijjah if you're not haji, and on voluntary. الزكاه, he does not stop at the 2.5%. He gives more sadaqah. He increases. الحج, تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة. He is always back and forth from حج and عمرة or عمرة and حج. He does more until I love this person. Until I love him. حتى أحبه. فإن أحببته, and if Allah loves you, كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به. I will be his hearing. Imagine, Allah is your hearing. Huh? يعني understand this in a way that he will direct you to hear the good things. تسمع القرآن, you hear the Quran. تسمع مجلس علم مثل هذا, a lecture like this. Huh? But if your ear is the ear of shaitan, huh? You will hear what? Music and baby stuff like that. Huh? تسمع القرآن هنا. والحديث يعني. الشاهد, or the important thing يا إخوة, is if you want to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then begin with the mandatory. Now something that comes before acting, which is knowledge, how to pray, how to fast. And this is the intention behind this class, inshallah, or this workshop or lecture series, whatever you want to call it, whatever name you want it to be called with. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we'll begin today. The way that I want to do it is I'm going to do just a half hour and then allow questions and answers. Sounds good? I already finished the half hour. It's gone. See, Abu Abdullah is looking at his watch. It's gone. Allah al-musta'an. طب يعني, give me bonus 10 minutes today. 10 minutes. هيا نعرف الصوم. Let's define what fasting is. وحكمه. بس. Let's define what fasting is and الحكم الصوم. بس. That's all we're going to do today. طيب. What is the definition of fasting? دايما يا إخوة, the definition in the language, linguistically, and the technical definition. So what is the linguistic definition of fasting? الإمساك والكف عن الشيء, that you abstain. I'm fasting, can't speak, I'm abstaining from speaking. Like Maryam, isn't that what she said? إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن. Anything. Abstaining. Very important. ولذلك هذا الموضوع الفاستنج هذا is very important, that when you want to run away, like somebody invited you to his house and you don't like the food. You don't like the food, and من حق المسلم على المسلم, the right of a Muslim upon another Muslim, that if he invites you, you should. يعني وإن كان هذا في الأمر يدخل فيه بقى شوية نقافه مش عارف إيه, يعني this is an issue, بس you could say I'm fasting. Not necessarily you're fasting from eating and drinking. I'm fasting and you think about something else. تعرض بالكلام يعني. And this is something that is permissible if you don't want to lie in Islam. But if you can make your brother happy and eat from the food, is a lot better. So what is the definition of fasting in the language? الإمساك والكف عن الشيء. Abstaining, stopping something. طيب, the technical definition of fasting. I want volunteers. What is the technical definition of fasting? الإمساك عن شهوتي البطن والفرج. Abstaining from fulfilling, that's his definition, two desires, the mouth and the private part. What would you say about that definition? Another good definition, abstaining from the things which would break your fast from dawn until the sun sets. But there is a key there that is missing. There is a cornerstone which is missing in those definitions. Your definition is correct. Your definition is correct. But that definition is missing a cornerstone. أحسنت. Right here. لأن ما واحد يقول لك إيه the people, the non-Muslims, they fast. They do not eat and drink. Why? Because it makes me healthy. وعندك حديث, there is a hadith out there that which they attribute to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يقول لك صوموا تصحوا. ولا ينسب هذا الحديث للنبي, وإن كان معنى صحيح. The meaning of the hadith is correct, بس هذا الحديث لا ينسب, غير صحيح, ليس له سند. Fast, you will be healthy. ف if you define fasting technically saying that it is abstaining from food, drink, or things which break your fast from dawn until the sun sets without throwing that restriction. Oh, here it is. الإمساك عن المفطرات من طلوع الشمس إلى غروب الشمس بنية التعبد لله. هذا هو التعريف. جامع, مانع. You abstain from eating, drinking, and all other things which will break your fast, which we will find out later, from dawn until the sunset, with the intention of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're doing this with the intention. ولذلك يا إخوة, النية ركن من أركان الصوم. ركن في ماهية العمل. هي النية شرط في الإيه, في الصلاة, في الأعمال الأخرى. النية is a condition, a prerequisite in the other acts, إنما الأعمال والنيات. لكن the intention is a pillar of fasting, one of the, without the intention, like if you wake up and you do not have the intention to fast and you fast. ولذلك من أهل العلم, some of the jurists, they made the condition that you must have an intention before dawn. من لم يبيت نية للصوم من الليل فلا صوم له, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, ورد هذا في حديث. If you do not have an intention before dawn to fast, your fasting is invalid. طبعا الكلام ده فيه تفصيل, يعني we'll come to it, we'll explain it. بس that is why we throw in that restriction, which is a الإمساك عن الطعام والشراب وسائر المفطرات بنية التعبد لله سبحانه وتعالى من طلوع الفجر إلى غروب الشمس. Abstaining from eating and drinking and all other things which will invalidate your fast from dawn until the sunset with the intention of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, نذكر quickly one hadith regarding the virtue of fasting in general. نبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا إخوة, كما في البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه, says ما من عبد يصوم يوما في سبيل الله إلا باعد الله بذلك اليوم وجهه عن النار 70 خريفا. Any servant of Allah who sincerely في سبيل الله, هنا sincerely, fast one day by the virtue of this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will distance his face from the hellfire the distance of 70 years travel. One day. حديث آخر عن سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه, والحديث في البخاري, إن في الجنة بابا يقال له الريان. جنة has how many gates يا إخوة؟ 8 gates. One of these gates is called the gate of الريان. والريان من الري, Because the fasting person would experience thirst. Ri means to be irrigated, to be given water. So one of these gates is called Ar-Rayyan. يَدْخُلُ مِنْهُ الصَّائِمُونَ. Only the fasting, those who used to fast, will be permitted, allowed to enter from that gate. لَا يَدْخُلُ مِنْهُ أَحَدٌ غَيْرَهُمْ. لَا يَدْخُلُ مِنْهُ أَحَدٌ غَيْرُهُمْ. Only them, only those who fasted, will be allowed to enter from this gate. يُقَال, it will be said, أَيْنَ الصَّائِمُونَ. Where are those who used to fast? فيقومون. Then they will stand up. لا يدخل منه أحد غيرهم فإذا دخلوا أغلق. When they enter Jannah from that gate, this gate will be shut. فلم يدخل أحد بعدهم. الحديث الآخر, آخر حديث إن شاء الله في مستدرك الحاكم, وحديث عبد الله بن عمرو ابن العاص رضي الله عنهما, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: القرآن والصيام يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. شوف يا إخوة, هذا اليوم يوم القيامة. Imagine to understand this hadith, to live the meanings of this hadith, you need to picture the day of resurrection. Day of resurrection, you're alone. Everyone will abandon you, even your family. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه. Oh, your brother will flee from you, your wife, your children, your father and mother. As a matter of fact, they would love to use you as a ransom. والله يبصرونهم يود المجرم لو يفتدي من عذاب يومئذ ببني. You would love, شوف, your own child, the child whom you love, you would use him or her as a ransom for you. يا رب, take my son and save me from the hellfire. So imagine, on this day يأتي الصيام, the fasting will come in a form that Allah knows best. Allah will transform fasting into a form which will speak. There are things which are metaphorical, like death, for example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the tongue of His messenger that death will be transformed into kapsh, a ram, horned ram. I don't know how. In McDonald's these days they sell